Hello everyone, this is Mamta Mond and today we will learn and solve chapter 15, exercise 15A, questions 1 to 10 of exercise 15A, chapter 15. Chapter name is Perimeter and Area of Class 6 of Composite Mathematics Textbook. If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for getting notifications of future videos. And please visit my blog messenger.com for more information regarding the textbook solution of CBSE, ICSE and other states board. Let's get started and solve some questions. Today we learn and solve exercise 15A, chapter 15, questions 1 to 10. Chapter name is Perimeter and Area. Let's solve some questions. Now question number 9. Multiple choice question. Find the length of a wooden strip. We have to find out in meter. That is the length of the wooden strip. We have to find out in meters. Required to frame a painting of length 54 cm and width is 32 cm. This is the wooden strip. And the length of a wooden strip in meters required to frame a painting of. This is the rectangular frame of paintings having length 54 cm, opposite sides are equal, this is also 54 and width is 32 cm, this is also 32 cm. First we have to find out the perimeter, that is the perimeter of this rectangular frame of this painting. Perimeter of this rectangular frame is 2 multiplied with length plus breadth. That is 2 multiplied with 54 cm plus 32 cm. 2 multiplied with 86 cm. 172 centimeter. Now we have to find out this length of the wooden strip in meters. So we know 100 centimeter is 1 meter. So 172 centimeter will be 172 divided by 100, that is 1.72 meter, and this is the answer. So option B, 1.72, this is correct. So length of the wooden strip will be length of wooden strip will be 1.72 meter. This is the answer. Option B is the correct answer. Now we solve question number 10, a multiple choice question. 4 square tables with sides 1.2 meter each are placed end to end to form one big rectangular table. What is the perimeter of this rectangular table? 4 square tables. This is one square table. This is second square table. This is third square table. And this is 4 square tables. 4 square tables with sides 1.2 meter each. So these sides of this square table is 1.2 meter. This is also 1.2 meter. This is also 1.2. This is also 1.2. All side, we know in square all sides are equal. So all are equal centimeter, that is 1.2. All squares have equal side, so all have equal length, that is 1.2 meter. This is also 1.2. This is also 1.2. This is also 1.2. And this is also 1.2 meter. Are placed end to end to form one big rectangular table. Now, these four squares form one rectangle. These square tables now form a rectangular table. Okay. Now we have to find out what is the perimeter of this rectangular table. First, find out the perimeter of this square. Perimeter of one square will be 4 multiplied with 1.2 meter. That is 4.8 meter. Now we have to find out the rectangular table. This is the side, that is the length of the rectangular table, 4.8, and breadth is 1.8 meter. Breadth is 1.8, that is width is 1.2 meter and length is 4.8 meter. Length of rectangular table is 1.2, 1 plus 1.2 plus 1.2 plus 1.2, that is 4.8 meter. Length is 4.8 meter and breadth is 1.2 meter. This is breadth. Now perimeter of the rectangle will be 2 multiplied with length plus breadth. 2 multiplied with length plus breadth. That is 2 multiplied with length is 4.8 meter plus 1.2 meter. Now perimeter will be 2 multiplied with 4.8 plus 1.2 will be 6.0. 6.0 meter, that is 12.0 meter. That is 12 meter. Option C is correct. So perimeter of the rectangular table is 12 meter. Option C is correct. If you have now subscribed
subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel. And if you have any doubts, then please write in comment section and I will reply. Keep learning, keep watching, and please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you. If you like this video, then please click the like button and share this. If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for getting notifications of future videos. If you have any doubts, then please write in comment section and I will reply. Keep learning, keep watching, and thanks for watching. Please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.